Thanks for staying with a few extra minutes with us this week. Lieutenant Governor John Sanchez is facing criticism right now after local media like KOB-TV and the Santa Fe New Mexican reported that he used campaign funds in 2014 to pay himself rent for campaign headquarters in a building he also owns. That would be $40,000 worth of rent. And Dan, even if your current laws are sort of vague on the issue, we've had a lot of this the past couple of weeks, you know, vague interpretations of certain laws. But for this one, was he right or wrong here? Is this a simple yes or no, right or wrong kind of a deal for you, or is it
middle? Well, no, there's a right or wrong, Gene.
Okay.
But like we always say, I mean, there's right or wrong doesn't always mean legal and illegal, right?
That's right.
And so I think clearly, I don't know anybody that donates to a politician that says, I'm giving you money in hopes that you're going to pay rent in your building to yourself,
right,
or that you're going to hire this person to do this. Or, you know, I mean, I just, it doesn't pass the sniff test,
right.
You know, right. And the answer being, well, I reported it, didn't mean, I wasn't hiding it.
Mm-hmm. Meaning Mr. Sanchez says he reported it.
I mean, the Lieutenant Governor saying I reported it. I just think it's not the right use of campaign funds. And I also think if you're one of those state reps or state senators on the Republican side that lost by a few votes, $40,000 could have made a big difference if it would have been given to somebody in one of those races to help them win another seat. And I think that's kind of what we expect from these leaders. Mm-hmm. I think it's a tough, you know, I would say clearly he's running for governor. But I'm going to tell you, in New Mexico, with all the stuff that's gone on with the Secretary of State, this is not something that's just going to roll off your back like water off
the back. There's not much wiggle room out there. Yeah,
yeah,
exactly. He calls him a frivolous, you know, accusation by political opponents.
I think is frivolous is his attitude, and before him, the attitude of Diana Duran, of using people's contributions. These are people that had faith in them to be a good candidates, good office holders, and this was used on personal purposes.
Mm-hmm.
And it's very disappointing. I guess gone are the days when somebody used a room in their own house. I think still it's true for the legislators.
Mm-hmm.
Used a room in their own house as their campaign office and then declared it as an in-kind contribution to themselves. This is absolutely the reverse. And also the length of time that this office was used. Sometimes, you know, your
That's
friend would...
And you're unopposed. Mm-hmm.
And you're unopposed. You know, it just does not pass the smell test at all.
Mm-hmm. And it goes back to 2011, another situation, 2011 as well. So again, the smell test, but even beyond that, the legalities of all this, I'm curious if we're going to see some kind of tightening of certain rules as all this comes together as time goes along.
Well, I mean, I think we already are in a conversation about campaign financing, campaign funding, and how individuals spend the money. I think what's interesting, one of the things that's interesting about this particular situation is certainly in 2011 and later, we didn't have the transparency, or should we say we didn't have the sunshine, right?
Right.
You knew that you could file your campaign reports and that they would sit in paper copy somewhere at the Secretary of State's office. And then it would take real effort to dig those back out.
Right.
And what we're seeing the state is moving toward, slowly, the ability for journalists and individuals to dig that information out more easily.
Mm-hmm.
So I think whether it's legal or not legal, whether our laws change, we're going to see that stuff that might have flown before is going to hurt you in the election.
Let's assume, Phil Marquez, that Dan's right and he's going to run for governor this next cycle. How damaging is something like this?
Well, your opposition is always going to take advantage of it.
Yeah.
It's legal. Change the law.
Mm-hmm.
If it's one of those type of things that's going to give an opportunity for someone to break, to make it look bad, then why is the law there? I mean, change the law.
Mm-hmm.
The campaign financing that you're talking about has to be gone after and taken a serious look at.
Mm-hmm.
I think you're right. It doesn't look good.
Mm-hmm.
Is it something you can do? Sure. But should you do it? No. That's a lot of money.
Is it the amount of money? It's funny you just said that. Would you be okay with 10 grand? I mean, you know.
No, I wouldn't have been happy with it at all.
Yeah.
Because I think the bottom line is using the office, like you were saying
That's right.
earlier.
That's right.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
But to actually take this building, this large building, and say that it was used for storage, and we did this and we did that, I mean, it just doesn't look good. Right. The bottom line is we had the people in the state of New Mexico already have a problem with politics anyway. Mm-hmm. So why add right. this look that says we're a bunch of crooks right. somehow or not?
That's right. And I think it's yeah. different if, mm-hmm. you know, I think to some extent, you know, from what the article said that, mm-hmm. you know, if you break down the rent payment was extremely higher than anything in the surrounding area. I think there are some acceptable.
$2,000 a month.
I think there are some acceptable things. Look, if this was a strip mall out on Manal, and you had a client that you had a renter that left, and you said, look, I'm going to rent it to the campaign, and there's a sign up, and you have staff there. I get that. You're going to charge the same rent because you shouldn't take a loss, right? You shouldn't say, I've moved Peter Piper's Pizza out, I've moved my campaign in. But I'm going to charge them the fair market value rent. It's going to go into doing. I'm okay with all of that. That mm-hmm. stuff. That stuff. I think passes the sniff test. What doesn't pass the sniff test is when you go out and you say, "Well, I charged myself $40,000. It's this giant barn that's in a part of town that nobody really goes to. No one's knows sure what's going on. He said he used it for campaign events. Mm-hmm. It's going to be interesting to see how many folks come forward and say I was at a campaign event at that facility.
Ah,
and I think at the end
point.
Of the day, it creates just another level of questioning. And if you're right. going to look at running for that office, you know, you either got to be willing to address it. And now let's also say this, the lieutenant governor can make this go away in a minute.
With
you know,
check?
He can turn around,
how could
turn
it?
Around and write a $40,000 check back and say, you know what, bad decision, bad, you know, in the Marine Corps, we used to say good initiative, poor judgment.
Sure.
Good initiative, poor judgment, $40,000 back to the campaign, and I apologize, and you know what?
Right.
You people are right. I should have been a better steward of the money, and I've learned from it.
If the noise gets loud enough, do you think that would happen?
Well, I think it's going to be hard to do it because
there's
I think...
There's a limited window, right?
Yeah, there's a limited window, and mm-hmm. sometimes, and I don't know if I'm saying this correctly, mm-hmm. sometimes when people take $40,000, it's... they need the money. I mean, there's, you know, it's, they're not readily available to write a $40,000 check out of their pocket back. But I do think the thing that's going to be interesting mm-hmm. is even with all of this stuff, you know, and this is something I'm sure we're going to get some emails about, the citizens of the state are very forgiving, and the citizens of the state have a very short memory. Mm-hmm. And the citizens of this state, lots of times, will just laugh off one of these things
yeah.
and say, but it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
And we've seen it with legislators, city yeah. councilors, county commissioners.
No, I think Phil said it. Yeah. I think Phil
it's
said
we see it.
It's very true, though. It's very true.
But the opposition will bring it up.
That's right.
The opposition is going to bring it up.
But yeah. I think the people, I think even though the opposition brings it up, I think lots of times, you look at all the arguments that are brought up by Republicans to Democrats, Democrats to Republicans, I think people get tone deaf to it, and I think they just kind of like, well, and it'll be interesting. He's clearly going to run for governor. Mm-hmm. Let's see what it affects. I would say today he's probably the Republican front runner mm-hmm. to win the nomination, but we'll see what that means. I mean, we'll see who, you'll be able to tell how this is playing by the other people that filed to run for governor.
That's a good point. Thank you all. Really appreciate it.